Look ahead means as you solve one thing, you're looking ahead to other things that you're going to solve next so that you don't have to pause in between. Look ahead is incredibly important as it can be the difference between somebody who averages 12 seconds and somebody who averages 6 seconds. But it's not so straightforward because there are many times when you solve something and you can't see anything else you're about to do. Because of this, look ahead is not just a thing you know about and start doing. It's something you have to actively practice and get very good at. So before look ahead will actually become useful to you, here are some things you have to be able to do first. So if you have a pair like this, one of the steps of F2L is to make sure that they're both in the top layer. But this isn't the best way to do it because with advanced F2L, which is shown in this video, you have to be able to get them into the top layer while pairing them up at the same time like this so that you can insert it right away. You also have to do special cases like this efficiently and also know how to do them into the back slot to avoid rotations. Those are just some of the things covered in the advanced F2L video, and you have to be at least decent at all of them to be able to move on. Next, anytime you see two pieces from an F2L pair, you have to be able to instantly know how to insert this into the correct slot. In my advanced F2L video, I told you how to compare stickers here to learn how to pair these up like that, but that's just the first step. Eventually, you want to have practiced these all so much that once you see these two, you know instantly how you're going to insert it into the back, and the pairing step is just part of the process that you have all in your muscle memory. So in other words, anytime you see an F2L pair, you have to be able to do it quickly and without looking. Because if you had to look at it, that means you're not really familiar with what you have to do in order to solve it. So to test if you're at this level yet, every time you see an F2L pair, just close your eyes and then do it as fast as you can with the fastest turns that you can possibly do. And then, so that there it is, and then just stop, look at the cube, and then do the next one as fast as you can. So if you can always do all of those, then you're definitely ready for look ahead. And if you can do those, chances are you currently average between 15 and 25 seconds. You may average over 25 and still find all of those to be true for you because you happen to turn slower than other people, and that's totally fine. Just make sure you're honest with whether or not you can do those things. Otherwise, look ahead won't really be useful to you at all, and you should keep working on those. Now we'll talk about the most important thing about look ahead. This phrase, slow down and look ahead, has been very popular in the speed cubing community, and it really boils down to two important things. Obviously, slow down and look ahead, but that creates two new questions, which is how slow should I go, and how exactly do I look ahead? So the look ahead part means to look away from the pair that you are currently solving, because you should be so good at solving these pairs that you don't need to look at them to solve them. Although by now it's probably an ingrained habit to look at this while you solve it, but we are going to try and get rid of that habit. So I'm going to try and look at other pairs while I solve this. And for now, we're just going to fixate on a corner. So here I'm going to start pairing them up and I'm going to look at this corner. So just watch the white sticker of it and watch how I'm going very slow as I do that. And we see it ends up here. Not very hard to track if I go that slow. And now for the same pair, I want you to watch the edge that went with that. So again, not very hard to track if you're just watching the edge. The hard part is going to be finding the corner and edge and tracking them both at the same time, which seems like a very big task to ask for when you used to just look at the current pair you were solving. The more experience you have, the more you'll just be able to visualize in your head preemptively how approximately they're going to move, which sounds like I'm not really telling you anything, but because there are so many different possible F2L cases interacting with each other, it takes a lot of time to develop the intuition needed to see how these pieces move. You shouldn't really flowchart how pieces move very often. You should just get a feeling of how they move by doing a lot of experience. So now is when practice is super, super important. So now for slow down and look ahead, we know what it means, but we don't know exactly how slow to go and where exactly we should look. So first I'll answer the question of how slow you should go. There are two answers to this, and it depends on what your goal is. If you're working on look ahead as an exercise, then you want to go as slow as you need to go for it to still be challenging to not pause. So for example, I'm solving this one. If I go this slow, it is very easy for me to think very hard about how I'm going to do these as I'm doing those, and now I see this. So this is probably too slow for me right now, based on my level of skill for look ahead. And in the beginning, this may actually still be too fast for you because you're not used to all the places you're supposed to look. So in the beginning, this is a totally fine speed to go at just for practice. But if you find that it's not challenging for you anymore, then there is no point and you should speed it up a little bit to improve your look ahead skill under more realistic, fast turning conditions. So if you've regularly been doing slow turning look ahead exercises and you now just want to go for faster solves because it's good practice or you have a competition coming soon, then you just want to slow down a little bit. And a little bit is very vague, but here's an example. The fastest I would normally be able to solve this is something like that. Then you probably now want to turn at about this speed. Notice how in these two, the speed is not that different, but the movement of the pieces is far easier to track in the one where I went slightly slower. This will vary depending on your level of look ahead, so you may have to go slower or you may even be able to go faster than this depending on how good you are at look ahead. But if you can look ahead while almost going at your regular turn speed, this video probably isn't for you. So now let's discuss the second part of this and where do we look ahead to? Often just slowing down to find pieces isn't enough because you don't know where to look, and sometimes the spots you look are not the spots where pieces are going to be. And this gets very advanced when it comes to deducing where pieces are or memorizing things, but here I'm just gonna get you started with a very simple concept. So first of all, there's a factor of what's easier to find, corners or edges. And the answer is probably gonna be corners because they have white or your cross color on them, and those are easier to spot. So I'm gonna start solving this and then just watch this white corner right here, and we're gonna find out what color is on it and then where it finally ends up. So there it is. And if you were watching more than just the white corner, you would have realized that its corresponding edge was right here, although that can be hard to find if you're not used to this. So anytime you solve a slot and you find a corner in the top layer, hopefully, there may not be any in the top layer, which is a bad case, but we're just gonna assume for now there always will be one. Chances are its corresponding edge will also be somewhere in the top layer because there are four slots it can be in the top layer while only four spots it can be in the middle layer, but you would have solved a slot, so chances are it's in the top layer. And if it's in the top layer, all the U moves you just did earlier from solving this pair should have made it not very hard to spot as you did those moves. And then you can just go and solve this pair afterwards. So that was the simple case, they were all in the top layer. So now I'm gonna solve the same one. The corner, same corner is right here. And this time I don't see its corresponding edge anywhere. And so if it's not in the top layer, it's gotta be in one of these slots. So that's where you're gonna look next. The front slot is very easy to see because you can see both of its colors, but the back slots are a little harder to see. In this case, this one is yellow, so it's obviously not the one that goes with this, so it must be that one. But that can take a while to deduce, and that is quite advanced. So how can you make this easier on yourself? Let's say we got the same case, say, from over here, before we started doing it. Then, in this case, we would have to rotate to here. Or to here. The best way to rotate is so that we're inserting this into a back slot, because when we insert it into the back slot, we have the same corner here now, but its edge could be anywhere in the top layer, of course, or it can be any of these two front slots, and if it's not there, then finally we look at the back slot, and there's only one spot remaining. So look ahead can be immensely easier if you just solve back slots earlier rather than later. And if you have two solved back slots, then you never have to look there again. So once you find the corner, you know its edge has to be either in the top layer or the front two slots, and that makes looking for it far easier. Now, I'm not saying that when you get this case, you should do a Y2 rotation because that's slower. If you get it from a case where you do have to rotate, such as you're facing this way or you're facing this way, and you do have to rotate to solve it, then you should rotate so that it's going into a back slot. Now, of course, there are times when you can find an edge before you find its corner, and that's totally fine. You don't have to find the corner first. I'm just showing this particular method of look ahead as one way you can get started, and it is very effective. Now, here's the cross done, just an example F2L with emphasis on all of the things that I talked about. So here I have these two, and I'm going to pair them like that, and then insert it into which way should I rotate? Back slot. And then this one and this one, and I'm going to rotate, so I'm inserting into a back slot. As I do that, I'm just gonna take note of what I have here. I have this one and this one, so I'm going to watch where those move, and then go into this one next, and inserting it again into a back slot. So anytime I have to rotate, just do back slot. Only if I have to rotate. I'm not gonna do unnecessary rotations. And then these two. So now a quick review of what we talked about. Look ahead is very important, but only if you are already pretty good at doing your F2L solutions efficiently and without much thinking. Once you can do that, you want to slow down and look ahead. Slowing down either means going slow enough that you don't have to pause just as an exercise, or going just a little slower than your regular turn speed if you're still trying to get fast times. You should generally do a mix of this practice, don't just pick one over the other. And then for where to look, try to find corners first because they will be easier to find. You don't have to do it this way, but this is just one method that you can stick to that is very reliable. After you find the corner, look for its edge, which can either be in the top layer or in any of the slots. So you want to insert into back slots more often so that you don't have to look into those back slots to find your edge. And again, this is not always going to work and you don't always have to do this, but it's a very reliable technique that will help to get you started. And once you start practicing look ahead and you want to start getting some new ideas or optimizing the things you're doing, then check out my advanced F2L playlist in the description. Look ahead is a very big concept, and I have a bunch of videos that are specific to certain parts about look ahead. For example, how to take advantage of memorizing where certain pieces are, how to track piece movement better, how to practice better, and so on. So thanks for watching. I hope you learned a lot, and I'll see you guys next time.